Okay, Be'ezrat Hashem, we're going to start Daf Yutet. Very interesting discussion about people traveling from one city to another city. Let's see how the Gemara says it. So the Gemara says, Sam, Haita Ketuva B'Sam, B'Sam, what is it? Sam, Sikra, Kumus, and Kankatom. That's the quadruplets over there that we don't allow. So the Gemara says, what's Sam? Sama. Look in Rashi. Sama, Zarnich. Belashon Kodesh. I never heard of Zarnich in Lashon Kodesh. Ur Pminto Belaaz. Ur Pminto. Upermint. What exactly is Upermint? Let's see if we get it.
Tzevetzahov
is yellow?
Yeah.
Okay. So Sama is yellow. Upermint.
Who says this from Maseret Chulin?
He has over here. Oh, this is
very hard to discern.
Rabba Sakarta, Sikra, Amara Barbahana, Sakarta Shema. Rashi says, Seva Adom, Shesovim Botrisim. It's the red color that they paint the shutters. Oh, he must have done it on the Mishnah. Here's the Mishnah. Kankantom, Harta de Ushkafe, Rashi, Seva Shesovim Bo Min Alim Shehorim. It's a black color that they use to color shoes.
It was to make the ink dry fast.
What?
I thought it was to make the ink dry fast.
Rashi here says it's a black color that you use for shoes. Tosfot is upset. Tosfot says, Kankantom harta d'ushkafe, pirisha kuntrus. It's not Rashi over here, it's Rashi in Eruvin. He says that's arminta, or adarmin. Rekashia, the imken, yehe asu latir armin l'tochadio. Because the Gemara said in Eruvin, that Rabbi Meir went to Rabbi Ishmael, he told him, Amalach Techa, he says, Sofer Alavlarani. He says, be careful. He says, no, I put Kankantom, don't worry. He says, Kankantom, you're not allowed because you need the Katavu Mahak. And when you put Kankantom, it doesn't erase. So he says, according to Gemara's Mashma, you shouldn't put Kankantom in the Dior. And if you say Kankantom is Armin, he says, and we put it. Right? Mami, now you see the Kankantom love Aramin. Can't be Aramin because we're putting it. The Achinami Mash Mahatam. The Mefaresh, the Amad, the Kankantom, Asumishum, the Khtiv, the Khatav, Umaha. Tavshi Yacholim Chol. The Dios, Yeshbo, Kankantom, and Yacholim Chol. The Emken, Kankantom, Shmami, now Kankantom is not Armin. Share Bechol Yom, Anumatirim, Armin, Litocha, Dioshela, Anuvafilu, Hachi, Machkir, and Leshapir. It's easily erased. So it can't be. Right? V'nir'eh k'depirish nashbam be'eruvin. T'kankantom haynu vitriol. Vitriol is copper sulfate. V'nihi d'amrinan hatam. Shehi yiruka, even though we say in Masechet Eruvin that it's green, mikol makom yesh lomar shemashchere k'sheshochakim oto hadek. So it becomes black when you make it fine. It also could be that when you put it in the Dior, it just gives it a stronger, what's it called? But over here, it's mashma that you're writing it with a direct kankantom, not kankantom in the Dior. Maybe it becomes black when you cut it down. According to Rashi, it's either harta d'ushkafe. He doesn't say how he explains it. And do they put vitriol into the shoemaker's thing? Ushkafe is clearly a shoemaker. The Gemara says, Diftera, Demaliah, Vekamiah, Velo Afitz. Diftira refers to paper. Niyar is what's it called? Okay. Diftira is the kamaliach. When you make a parchment, you have to salt it first to prevent it from decaying. Then you use some sort of a paste with kemah in it to help do something. And then they put afatzim, which is gold nuts or gold, oak gold, in order to tighten it up. So this guy, he put melach and kemah, but he didn't put the afitzim. He didn't put the oak gold that have tannin that cause it to contract. So it's not fully worked. Tosafot is bothered. Rashi, kamiach b'mayim v'lo afitz me'uvad b'afatzim shekurim gals. Tosafot says, diftera demaliach v'kamiach v'lo afitz. Kashia imken heyach kotvim al kelafim shelanu. Tosafot says, in our times they stop putting afatzim on the cloth. So how do we write it? V'lo afitzi. Sefer Torah, tefilin u'megila, v'tiretz rabbeinu tam, sh'asid shelanu notnim b'kelafim. They used to work it with lime. Mehanika afatzim. It functions the same as afatzim. Veteida, proof is, the gitin amar de belo afitz yachol is dayev, that if you don't put afatzim in, you'll be able to erase it. And you won't know the difference. And you'll be able to forge it, right? Veshelanu en yachol is dayev ala lavan. If you write on the white side, you won't be able to forge it, you'll be able to notice the erase. So therefore, it's clearly equal. And they say the Rambam holds the same way. The Mishnah says, Achete ketuba latzit. Achete Gemara says, Achete ketuba ashurit. It has to be written in Hebrew, our script. Dichtiv kechtavam v'chizmanam. It has to be in their writing. Right? Ashurit is our writing. Ala sefer ubidyo. On Sefer and with Dio Minala, and Sefer is cloth with Dio Minala. Atya Ketiva Ketiva. We learn a Gezerah Shabbat. Ketiv Hata Hacha. But Techtov Esther Malka. Esther Malka wrote the Megillah. Ketiv. Vayomer Lahem Baruch. Baruch said, how was this writing that you were doing? Mipiv Yikra Elai et Kola Devarim Ele. He read it from his mouth to me all these words. Vani Kotev. I was writing Ala Sefer with Dio. On parchment with ink, so therefore you see it has to be Sefer and Dior. Dior is our type of ink.
So, how do we say Sefer?
Cloth? Yeah. It's this Rashi says it in the Mishnah that Sefer is cloth. But Kanere, that was the choice item for writing Sefarim. But I'm not sure.
We talked that. Yeah, speaking.
What's Al HaSefer? What's Al HaSefer?
Are things that are considered to be sefer? You see, they have at least four different formats. They didn't have paper. Paper goes back to.
Rashi said cloth and then.
Okay. Ben Ir Shahalach Likrach. Somebody who lives in a city. The city reads on the 14th. Shahalach Likrach. He went to a walled city that reads on the 15th. When should he read? Uben Krach Shahalach La'ir. Or a person from a walled city who's supposed to read on the 15th. Went to the city, you're supposed to read on the 14th. Right? That's what Rashi says. Ben Ir Shizmano Be'arba'asar. Shalach Lekrach Shizmano Be'hamishas. So we say, Em Atid Lahazor Limkomo. If he's going to go back to his place, Korek Imkomo, he reads like his place. Ve'im Lav, but if he's not going to go back to his place, Korek Imahem, he reads with them. Umehechan, that's all. Rashi says, when is he supposed to go back? What are we talking Mehechan kore adam et ha-megillah. From where should you read the Megillah? V'yetze b'yedei chovah, and you'll be yotzer. Rabbi Meir omer kula. Rabbi Meir says you have to read the whole Megillah. Rabbi Yehuda omer meish Yehudi. You have to start from Ish Yehudi. Rabbi Yossi omer me'achar devarim ha'ele. From when he made Hamandig, the beginning of the plot. Rashi says, korekim komo. If he's going to go back, he reads like his place. Kehovat mekomo. Ben ir ba'arba asar. Ben krach ba'chamisha asar. And we'll see, even though he's in the other place, he'll read like his place. Amar Rava. Rava explains. Rashi says Rava is talking about a ben krach shalach la'ir, the second case. A person who's in a walled city and he goes to an unwalled city. So if he goes by where he came from, he has to read on the 50th. If he goes by where he is, he has to read on the 14th. So Rashi, the Gemara says, Amar Rava, lo shanu, that a person who goes from a walled city to a not walled city, and he's going to go back, he reads like his place, right? If he's going to go back, he reads like his place. Ella only she'atid lahazor beleleyu dalid, that he's going to go back on the night of the 14th, meaning he's in a city that has to read on the 14th. If he's going to get out of there before their main obligation starts, which is in the morning of the 15th, on the morning of the 14th, then he reads like his place. But if he's going to be in the unwalled city, where the chiyuv is on the 14th, at the main time of the chiyuv, which Gemara is going to assume is the morning, is daybreak of the 14th, then he becomes a pruz ben yomo, like the Gemara is going to say, you become an unwalled city for that day, and therefore you get an obligation to read on the 14th. And then you don't have to read on the 15th. Lo shanu ela she'atid lahazor b'leilei yudal. It's only if you're going back on the night of the 14th. Aval en atid lahazor b'leilei arba asar. If he's not going back on the night of the 14th, kore imahem. He reads it with them.
In other words, where he is in daybreak,
that's what decides who he is.
What he is, right?
Who he is. Right. If he's not going to go back on the night of the 14th, he's going to be there on daybreak of the 14th. Korei mahem. He reads it with them. Rashi. Lo shanu. We didn't learn. The ben karach, that a person who lives in a walled city. Shalach li, that went to an unwalled city. The atid lahazolim kum, and he's going back to his city. Korei b'hamisha asar, he reads it on the 15th. Ve'lo ab'arba asar, ela shatid lahazor ve'leil arba asar. Only if he's going back on the night of the 14th. Im. Kodem amud ha'shachar. Before daybreak, yetzeh min ha'ir, he's leaving the city. Hu dekatani, that's what we meant. She'eno tzarich lekrot imahen ve'leil yudalit. He's not going to read on the night of the 14th. Even though he's still there, they're all reading the Megillah and he's home playing video games. Right? Since in the day, you're not considered even an unwalled city person, a pruz for one day. If he's not planning on leaving during the night, now you're considered an unwalled person for that day. Afal pi she'atid lahazor lemahar ulyom acher, even though he's going to go back tomorrow or the next day, nikra pruz. Since you're in the unwalled city at daybreak, you become a pruz.
Location, not where you're from.
Depends on
right.
Location and time.
Bekore imahem, and he reads with them, ben belele yudalid, ben bi yudalid, the night of the 14th and the 14th. Duadin, says Rashi. The same thing will be in the opposite. Lebin Ir, somebody that comes from an unwalled city. Shalach Likrach, that goes to the walled city. Ematid lahazor belele tetvav. If he's planning on going back home on the night of the 15th. Shelo yehesham beyom tetvav, that he's not going to be there on the day of the 15th. Lo have mukaf liyomo. He's not going to be a walled city for the person for the day, and therefore korebi udalid, you read on the 14th, kehovat mekomo, like your place. Vafapishu bekrach, even though he's in the walled city, if you're not going to become a ben krach, then you stay, you're ben ir. Aval en atid lachazor b'lele yud tedvav, if you're not going back on the night of the 15th. En tzarich likrota b'yudalad, you don't have to read it on the night of the 14th. Umamtin v'korei mahem, and he waits and then he reads it with them. Afalpish is a fola hazor la haziman, even though he's going back and technically he's still a unwalled city person, but since he's going to be in the city on the 15th, he's going to be considered a walled city person, and he reads on the 15th. Over here we have a special deen of Peruz Ben Yomo. Prophet says, Amarava, Mina Aminala. How do I know that this deen is different than the regular deenim of Minhag Mekomo? So he says, Dichtiv, like it says, Al Ken, therefore, Hayehudim Aperazim, the Jews from the unwalled city, Hayoshvim Be'are Aperazot, who dwell in the unwalled cities. What do you think I thought that Yehudim HaPerazim meant? Clearly it means the Jews that live in the unwalled cities. So why do you have to go back and repeat, Hayoshvim Be'arei HaPerazot, to teach me even if you're not a Perazim, even if you're only there for one day? The Ribuy of Hayoshvim Be'arei HaPerazot says, even if you're only there temporarily, but you're there for one day, you're considered a Peruz. Let's see. Mechti, Ketiva Yudim, Aperazim, it already says the Jews of the unwalled cities. Lamali, Lemichtav, what do you have to write? Hayoshvim, Be'are Aperazot, that dwell in the unwalled cities. Hakamash, Balan, it's teaching me, Tipruz, Ben Yomo, Nikra, Pruz, that an unwalled city person for the day is called the Pruz, meaning that the guy from the walled city who gets to the unwalled city and he's there at daybreak, he becomes a Pruz. And if we have to meet on the 14th, Ashkacham Pruz, I find that if you come to an unwalled city and you're there for the day, even though Be'etzim, since you're planning on going back home to the unwalled, to the walled city, you're Be'etzim a Ben Krach, but since you're going to be in the unwalled city for the day of Purim, we have a special name for you of Pruz Ben Yomo. Okay, very good. So it's possible for a guy from the walled city to get an obligation to meet on the 14th because he's a Pruz Ben Yomo. But how do you know that it's reversible? Right, Ashkacham Pruz. Mukaf minnal, and how do you know that you can become a mukaf liyomo? So Gemara sevarau, it's logical. Be the pruz ben yomo karui pruz. Since the unwalled city people can be a pruz for the day, mukaf ben yomo karui mukaf. A person who's unwalled for the day, who's walled for the day, is called a mukaf. That's all. That's the way Rashi learns. Rashi learns that everything depends on where you're going to be at daybreak, on the time of the chiyuv of the place that you're in. If you're in the walled city, in the unwalled city, depends on where you are on the morning of the 14th. If you're in a walled city, where you're going to be on the morning of the 15th. According to Rashi, in theory, right? If you have a guy who's a Ben Krach, Ben Ir, let's say, lives in the 14th, so he read it on the 14th. Then he moves to the 15th.
He moves. He went to Yerushalayim, let's say.
He went to Yerushalayim, or maybe he moved to Yerushalayim.
In the apartment?
Maybe. Yeah. On the night, on the 14th, after daybreak.
Right. Okay.
So he read on the 14th. Now he goes to Yerushalayim, then he became Hayav on the 15th.
He was in the hotel on the 14th.
And then you have the opposite. You have the opposite. You have a guy who was in the 15th on the 14th. And then he moves to...
He didn't read.
Right? He was planning on staying. Or he lived there.
He missed both.
So anyway, then he moves to the 14th. Maybe he missed both. The Rashba says maybe that could happen. The Rambam learns the whole thing differently. The Rambam learns, and that's how Maran is posek. He learns that everything depends on where you wanted to be when you left. It's as if when you left your place, you come. The Rambam learns that Rava is going on the beginning. Ben Ir Shehalach Likra. Im Atid. Bring me a Mishnah Berakhah.
If that's the case, the walled city is going to have two minyans. You're going to have to have one on the 14th, you're going to have to have one on the 15th.
Maybe. He says if you planned, if you know, he says like this. No, if you left your unwalled city, planning to come back for Purim, and you went to a world city, even if you got delayed and you wound up there for the 15th, you still read on the 14th because you planned on being home. But if you planned on staying there, then you read on the 15th.
You commute to Yerushalayim the 14th. It's in a hotel, exactly.
All of it doesn't make a difference because the Maaseh we hold, Maran holds like the Rambam, and everything depends like this. Ben Ir shalach lekrach, or Ben Krach shalach leir. If when he left, he planned on coming back to his place in the time that he's supposed to read it in his place. The Magid says, if he's planning on being back in his place by the time that they can read it in the place that he went to. Meaning, he's going from a city, from an unwalled city, to a walled city. If he's planning on leaving before the morning of the 15th, anytime before. Vinitakev, very funny. And then he got delayed, and he couldn't leave. Since he didn't plan on being there for the morning of the 15th, he'd be there on the 14th. Or, if you were... Ben Ir Shalach Likra. I'm reading Shalach. Emayada Ato Be'ed Nisiato. Lahazor Lim Komov is Mankiria. If he wanted to come back to his place in the time when he's reading it. Rotel Omar is Mankiria Shotetvav. Dainu Mishira Yom. Lo Yesham. By daybreak he won't be there. Kiyazor Misham. He's going to leave there Kodimora Yom. Avshel Basof Roe. He sees Shu Mukrach Letakevsha. Gotta stay. I didn't finish my business. Gamal Yom Tetva Mikol Makom Enu Nekra B'Shem Mukaf. He's not called a Mukaf because he didn't plan when he left. He didn't plan on staying there. The Kore B'Yom Yudalit. He reads it on the 14th. B'Yoto B'Krach when he's there. Aval and Be'en Nisiato Lo Ayav Da'ato LaHazom Min Akrach Al Ela LaHazman Akriyat. When he left, he was planning on staying there through the 15th. Da'inu B'Boker Shel Tetva Sha'az Hu Kivar Zman Kriyat. As Chal Alav Shem Mukaf, the Korei Maimi reads with them on the 15th. Va'afilu Imachar Haka Hazar Le'iro B'Yom Tetvav. Even if he went back to the city, Korei Sham, if you didn't read it when you were in the city, you got to read it back in your city. The opposite. Ben Krach, a 15th guy that went to the city. If when he left, he was planning on being there. If he was planning on being home before the night of the 14th, before the morning of the 14th, even though he stayed there, he reads like his place on the 15th. But if when he left, he planned on staying there for the 14th. This is then. That's what's different. Listen. Aval im lo yabed atobe nesiato la hazon misham rak la har zman kriya. Dainu biyom yudalid halalav chovata kriya shelayir. Then he has to read it with the city. Okay.
Right. And give me a scenario. You live in New York. You went to Tel Aviv. You went to Yerushalayim the 14th. You slept in the hotel the 14th. You woke up in the morning. You went to Tel Aviv. You're missing both. According to what you said, because I'm not going back home. It's not my home. Over here, you're missing everything.
According to, where were you planning on being when you got to Tel Aviv? According to him, everything depends on your plan. You can never miss both, according to him, it seems.
So if you're only 14 in Yerushalayim, and you're going tomorrow to Tel Aviv, following the Tel Aviv, so when you read it, I'm slipping the 14 in Yerushalayim, over Hayat, actually, 15. The following one, you're going to Tel Aviv. I'm going to Tel Aviv.
So you're planning to be there, so you have to be reading on the 14th.
Where?
If you're not planning on being in your place, if you're not planning, according to the
Rambam. What's my place mean?
According to Maran, if you're not planning on going back.
Your place, you say.
I'm not going back. You're not planning on leaving. Let's make them go back to your place or go to Tel Aviv.
Your place, it's whatever place you're going to be in. Whatever
if you're not going to be in Yerushalayim on the morning of the 15th.
Morning of the 15th, I'm leaving.
I'm leaving in the morning. Go ahead.
When you leave? 1 or 4?
Check out. 9 o'clock. You're leaving in the morning.
Go. Morning of the 14th or the morning of the 15th?
15th. What's 15th?
15th is Yerushalayim. Then you're Hayav in Yerushalayim.
14 in the morning. 14 in the morning, I'm leaving Yerushalayim.
14 in the morning, in Yerushalayim. So you're not leaving Yerushalayim on the morning of the 15th? So then you have to read on the 14th. You have to read on the 14th. Let's see, next. The Gemara says, Am ve'amar Rava. Ve'amar Rava. Ve'amar Rava ben Kfar. Person from a village. She'alach le'ir, who went to the city. Ben-kach u-ben-kach korei mahem. Rashi says, even if he read already on the Yom HaKinisah, and then he goes to the city and he's there on the 14th, whether he left early, whether he didn't leave early, korei mahem, he reads with them. My ta'ama, what's the reason? Hi, this village guy, kibnei ha'ir bai l'mikre. Really, mikaradin, he was supposed to read on the 14th. But Rabbanan Uda Akilo al Kfarim, the Chachamim gave the Kfarim a leniency, kedei she'aspiku ma'im u'mazon lahem shebekrachim, so they should speak, or because they supply food to their brothers in the city. And Hani Mili, when do we give that leniency? Ki'ita beduchte, when he's home. Aval ki'ita be'ir, if he's in the city, kibnei ha'ir ba'i l'mikre, he has to read like the people in the city. Look in Rashi. Ben Kfar, shehekdim v'kara liyom ha'kinisa, he read to the Yom HaKinisa. V'harkach halach liyah, then he went to the city, v'ya sham leil yudalit. Ben kach u'ben kach, afilu atid lahazor v'latzet misham kodem ayom, even if he's leaving before the day, korei mahem balayla, he has to read in the night. Why? Because kibnei ha'ir ba'i mikre, really mi'ikar adin, you're a city guy. Kol ha'perazim, all the people that are not in walled cities, zimanam be'arba'asad, the time is really on the 14th. Ben kefarim ben ayarot. But Rabbananu da'akilu alayu la'akdim li'yom ha'kinisa. Rabbis gave them a leniency to go to the Yom HaKinisa. So now, even though you already read on Monday, and now it's Tuesday night, we only gave you the leniency if you're not going to be here. When you're in the village. A person who's from a walled city that went to the city, no matter what, he reads like his place. Says the Gemara, Ben Krach Salka Daita. Could you understand that Braita, the way it's written, that a person from a walled city goes to an unwalled city, no matter what, reads on the 15th? V'matid l'hazor talya, depends when he's leaving, like we said in the Mishnah. Elalav, the Tana who said over this Braita made a mistake, and it's supposed to be Ben Kfar. It's supposed to be a person of the village, and it says, Kore Kim Komo, he reads the Yom HaKinisah. So you see that village people are not overpowered by the people of the city, says the unwalled city. El alav ben kfar, says Rava told him, velav tirutzim et tarzat, you're not correcting the braita. Make another correction. Tani korei maim. Just like he got ben krach wrong, say korei maim, he reads it with them. It's mistaken braita. You can't ask me such a big question from him. Meheichan korei adam et ha-megillah. From where do you have to read the Megillah to be yotze? So the Gemara says, we have three shitot in the Mishnah. One was the whole thing. One was Ish Yehudi, and one was Ahara Devarim Ha'ele. Tanya Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai Omer, a fourth shita. Mi balayla ha'hu. From that night. Balayla didashinat ha'melo. Am Rabbi Yohanan v'kulam. All these four opinions. Mikra echad darshu. They're all understanding it from the same place. V'tichtov Esther Malka u'mordechai ha'yehudi et kol tokif. All the strength. Right? What is that? Manda Amar Kula. The one that says you have to read the whole thing. Tokfo shel Ahashverosh. The greatness of Ahashverosh. Look at Rashi. Tokfo shel Ahashverosh. Umitchila hi medaber betokfo ad sofa. From the beginning to the end is the strength of Ahashverosh. His party in 180 days. I gotta know what type of king I'm talking about. Manda Amar Miish Yehudi. Tokfo shel Mordechai. The greatness of Mordechai, how he became so powerful. So you got to start from where he was in the beginning. Manda Amar me'ahara devarim ma'ele, tokfo shel Haman. How great our enemy Haman was, and Hashem saved us from him. Umanda Amar balaylahu tokfo shel Nes. The greatness of the Nes, how Hashem disturbed his sleep, and so on. Ravuna Amar me'acha. Difference. Mara u'al kacha u'ma'gi alehem. Rashi. Umara ual kacha, ha-megillah nechteve, the Megillah was written, ve-nekret, and it's read, le-odia le-dorot, to tell the generations, mara u be-oto azman, she-asu ma she-asu, what they see, that they did what they did. Umifaresh, and then we say, al kacha. They did it because of this, al kacha asu. Ulefaresh, ma higi al-osim, and what happened to them? So again, man de-amar kula, the one that says the whole thing, mara ha-hashverosh, שנשתמש בכלים של בית המקדש. Why did the Hashverosh use the כלים of the בית המקדש? Al kacha, for this, משום דחישב שמים שנים, because he calculated the 70 years, ולא יפרוק, and he wasn't redeemed. ומה הגיע להם, and what happened to him? The קטיל ושתי. He wound up killing ושתי, lost his wife. מן דאמר מי איש יהודי, מה ראה מרדכי דקנה בהמן? Why was מרדכי antagonizing המן? Al kacha, because of this, the shavi nafshi avodah zarah. He made himself into an avodah zarah, or he wore an avodah zarah, or whatever. Uma higi alehem et rachish nisan. What happened in the end? Miracle happened. Man de amar me'ahara devarim ma'ille, from when Haman became raised, mar ahaman shenet kaneh bekol ha'yudim. Why did Haman get upset at all the Jews? Al kacha mishum de mordechai lo yichrav lo yishtahave. Uma higi alehem, what happened to them, to Haman? They hung him and his sons on the tree. Why did Ahashverosh bring this his memory book? Al kacha, because of this, does that mean to Esther lehaman behadeh? Because Esther invited Haman. Why is he inviting Haman? Like we said before. Umay gi alehem. And what happened at Rachish Nisa? We had a miracle. Amar Rabbi Halabo, Amar Rav Hama Bar Guri, Amar Rav. Halacha kedivrei Omer kula. The halacha is like the opinion of Bimeir that you have to read the whole thing. That's A. Of course, that's what we hold. The afilo leman damar miish yudi. Even according to the opinion that you could start from ish yudi, tzricha shetehe ketubah kula. The whole thing has to be written. You can read part of it according to him, but it has to be read from a whole scroll. The whole miracle has to be there. The Amar Rabbi Halabo, Amar Rav Hama Bar Guri Amarav. Megillah nekret sefer, venekret igeret. A Megillah is called a sefer, like it says, venechtav ba sefer. And it's called igeret, al devrei haigeret hapurim azot. So it's a letter and it's a book. So there's a compromise there. Nekret sefer, it's called a sefer, shem tafara bechute pishtan pesula. If instead of sewing it with the sinews that they use in the Sefer Torah, you sewed it with linen, it's pasul. When the Kreta get it, but it's called a letter, Shemetil ba shilosha hotegidin. If you put three strings of sinews, Keshera, it's kasher. Doesn't have to be fully done with sinew. So compromise. Amar of Nachman, Ubilvad shiyu mishulashim. They have to be tripled. Now the question is, what does triple mean? There's like four pirushim. Number one, Rashi says, Shiyeh merosh ha-tefer ad mekom tefirat agid ki mimenu ve'ad agid ha-sheni u menasheni le-shelishi ki mishlishi le-toch ha-sefer. It has to be, they have to be evenly spaced. Once, five spaces, right? One from the beginning of the sefer to the first gid, from the first gid to the second gid, second gi to the third gi to the end of the sefer. So they're equal distance from all of them. Others say one in the beginning, one in the middle, one in the end. Others say that every stitch has to be triple. V'nekret igeret. It's called the letter. Oh, fine. Amar of Nachman. Amar of Yudah Mashmuel. Hakore b'megillah ketubah ben haketubim. If you read the Megillah from the Megillah, that's part of a larger Sefer of Ketubim. Let's say I have a Hamesh Megillot. Has all five. Right? Lo Yatza is not Yotze. Why? Rashi. HaKetubah ben HaKetubim. Sefarim Sheyu Bimei Chachamim. Kulam Begilyon. The Sefer was written in a scroll. Kemo Sefer Torah Shelanu. Lo Yatza. Tebaina Nigeret Le'atzma. It has to be separate. The Mefarsem Nisat Fei, it makes a much more publication of the Nes to have a separate Megillat Esther. The Chikorah Ben HaKetubim, Nereh Kikorah Ben Megray, looks like he's reading Chumash or something. Amar Ava, Lo Amaran, Ela Delo Mechzer Al Miyat Rapurta. When is it not qualified if it's not distinct. But let's say you have this scroll, and the Megillah portion is a little bit shorter than the rest, or a little bit taller than the rest. So it's distinct, that's okay. Even though it's part of the larger compilation, since it's higher or shorter, it's okay. Rashi, imichzir aval, michzira omiyatra purta letlamba. Rashi says, michzira omiyatra arukami shara kelafim. Lemala o lemata, o ketzara mem, or it's shorter. V'yesh laheker la'atzma, it's kashe. Levi bar Shmuel, havekari kamed Rav Yehuda b'megillah ketubah ben haketubim. He was reading in front of Rav Yehuda, and the Megillah ran among the rest of the Sefer. Amar Le, he told him, Hare Amru, they said, HaKore b'megillah ketubah ben haketubim lo yatsa. If you read in the Megillah that's written among the rest of the Sefarim of Ketubim, you're not yotze. Amar Le, he said, lo yatsa. He said, he criticized him. Right? Amar Rabbi Chiya Bar Abba, Amar Rabbi Yohanan, HaKore b'megillah ketubah ben haketubim lo yatsa. Same statement. Umahu la amoha. And they hit him on the head when he said that. And they said, Hani mili. So he said, so the way they corrected that, this was all looking. He said, two people said, Kore b'megillah lo yatsa. Mahula moha. So he hit him back, he said, Bitzibur shanu. That's only reading in public. In public, you need more of a persumenisa. But in private, it's okay. Bitzibur shanu. Rashi, Mahula moha. Lehar sha'amar shimuazu ikal kot koda. Kilomah satar mikzata. He took away part of this statement. Va'amar lo amru ela bitzibur. It's only in public. Va'amar bichia baraba, amar biyohanan. Shiura tefer alacha la Moshe Misinai. Then he took it away. Then they hit him, it seems like. Lo amru ela kedei shelo yikra. Rashi, shiur ha-tefer, kishetofrim yiriot shel sefer Torah lechaberan yachad. When you saw them, mishayirim betefer lemal o lemat. You don't sew it all the way to the top of the page and the bottom. You leave a little space.
Stretching.
So he said, that's halacha l'Moshe Misinai. Mahu le'amoha, he says, it's not true. Lo amru ela kedei shelo yikra. Rashi, shem enu mishayir, mehadek pechoska. It's totally tight. Keshum et dekol sefer Torah. When he's tightening the scroll, vehu nikra, and it's going to rip. Aval achshav, keshum et dekol bekoach. When he's getting tight, umatchil arachiv, he sees the tips starting to spread. V'rotzo leikareya, monem ela dekol yoter. So it's like a warning mechanism. When you see the top start to separate, I'm pulling too tight. So it's not halacha l'Moshe Misinai. Amar b'chiya baraba, amar b'yohanan. Il malay nishtayer b'me'ara sh'amad bo Moshe v'Eliyahu kimlo nekev ma'ha tzidkit lo ayu yichulin la'amom b'nei ora. Right, when Moshe Rabbeinu was praying to Hashem, he said, I didn't have k'vodecha. So v'samticha v'nekra tatsur, I'm going to put you in the cave. V'sakoti kapi alecha, and I'm going to put my hands over you ad ofri. Meaning I'm going to protect you, that you shouldn't get damaged from the intense kiddushan, the intense light of Hashem's revelation. So he says, if Hashem would have left even like a pinhole, the light would have been overpowered him. Rashi, me'ara she'amad bo Moshe, kesh'avar HaKadosh Baruch Hu lefanav, she'ne'emar ve'samticha benekrat asur, ve'Eliyahu af hu amad be'ota me'ara. Eliyahu was also in the same cave. ועבר הקדוש ברוך הוא לפניו שנאמר ויבוא שם אל המעבר ויום יצא ועמדת בהר והנה השם עובד. So מחה צדקית שלנו, our type of needle, שהיא דקה, which is thin, ותופרים בה צדקי בגדים, you repair clothing with it. יש מחת אחרת גסה, there's a thicker needle, שנקראת מחת של סכאין, that they use for sewing sackcloth. אם מלין נשתייר בנקב, כפי מחת, כשעבר עליהם הקדוש ברוך הוא, כמו שנאמר, וסקותי כפי הדובריך, Alecha ad ovri. Okay. Shneimar, like it says, kilo yirani adam v'chay. Even a small part. V'amar b'chiya bar Abba, amar b'yohanan, my dichtiv, v'alehem, and on the luchot, kekol ha-devarim, like all the words, asher diber Hashem imachem bahar, that Hashem spoke to you on the mountain. What's kol ha-devarim? Melamed teaches us, Sherawa Kadosh Baruch Hu Moshe, Hashem showed Moshe, Diktuke Torah, the finer points of Torah that the rabbis understood, V'diktuke Sofrim, and the finer points of the Mishnah, Uma Sha'asofrim Atidim Lehadesh, and what the rabbis are going to be add to the Torah. Ma'iniu, what's that? Mikra Megillah, which, like we said before, is the only thing that they ever added as a standalone mitzvah, at least in the time of the Nevi'im. That's what it seems like. Rashi says, Diktuke Torah, Ribuyim Etim Vegamim. The Ribuyim of the Torah, Et Lerabotze, Gam Lerabotze. Mi'utin is Achim Verakim. The things that we exclude from Ach or Rak. Diktuke Sofrim Shediktiku Aharonim. Milashon Mishnat Arishonim. What they understood just from the way the early generation said over the halacha. And we said Mikra Megillah. Hakol Kesherim Likrot Et HaMegillah. Everyone is kasher to read the Megillah to be motzi other people. Chutz miHeresh Shoteh VeKatan. Except for Heresh who's deaf. Shoteh who's not intelligent, he's fool. The Katan and the child. Why? Because they're patur from the mitzvah, they can't be motzi other people. But Rabbi Yehuda machshir b'katan. Rabbi Yehuda says that a katan is okay. Man Tana Cheresh. Who's the Tana that says Cheresh? That if a guy can't hear. The Avad Nami Lo. He's not Yotze the Avad. So the Gemara understands, not the way I explain. The Gemara understands that the Cheresh that we're talking about, generally there's a Cheresh who's deaf and dumb. He can't speak and he can't hear. Many times it happens that because he can't hear, he can't speak. Right? But. But a person who's a Heresh like that is generally considered to be like a Shoteh because he can't understand anything people say. He can't learn. So that's Patur Mikol HaMitzvot. The Gemara over here seems to be talking about a Heresh whose problem is not that he's not intelligent. He knew everything. Then he lost his hearing. So he talks regularly, but he can't hear. So the problem with the Heresh is that he can't be Yotze. Why can't he be Yotze? Because if you can't hear it, you're not Yotze. The Gemara says, Man Tana Heresh Di'avad Namilo. Who's the Tana that holds that a Heresh who can't hear himself read the Megillah is not Yotze even B'di'avad? Amar Rav Matna Rabbi Yossi. It's Rabbi Yossi. The Tana, we have a Mishnah. We referenced this yesterday. HaKoreh Shema, if somebody reads Shema, V'lo Yishmiya Lo'ozno, and he didn't hear himself, Yatza, he's Yotze. That's like the Chachamim yesterday, right? We said, V'lo Yishmiya Lo'ozno, Yatza. Rabbi Yossi Omer, Lo Yatza. Rabbi Yossi says, he's not Yotze. Like Rabbi said, Shema, Hashma Le'oznecha, Mashalta, Motze Mipicha. Right? So Lo Yatza, even B'di Avad. When the Chachamim say, Yatza, B'di Avad. Right, Yatza. Doesn't say Kore Adam Shema Velo Mashmiya Lo'ozno. You could lechatchila read it without hearing it. No, it says if you read it and you didn't hear it, you yotze. But lechatchila hear yourself. So one tana holds b'di avadi yotze. One tana holds b'di avadi not yotze. Umimay the Rabbi Yosi he b'di avad nami lo. How do you know that the Mishnah, our Mishnah, is Rabbi Yosi, and he's saying that b'di avad if Heresh read it, he's no good. Dilma Rabbi Yudahi. Maybe it's the Tanakama, which is Rabbi Yuda. Who holds that if you read the Megillah, if you read Shema, and you didn't hear yourself with the Avad, you yotze. Ulchatchila hu dilo. And the Mishnah says everybody is kasher to read the Megillah, means that's who you should put up. So they say, except for a Heresh, then you can't put him up. But with the Avad, if he read it, he's yotze, because he's yotze without hearing himself. And since he's yotze, he can be motzi other people. Says Gemara, Hadi Avad Shapir Dami Lo Saka Daitach. It can be. The Katani Heresh Dum Yedeshuket Tevekatan. It says the Heresh like the Shotev Katan. The Shotev Katan is not Kasher, not Lachatchila, not B'di Avad. And because they put the Heresh in the same sentence, it must be he's also pasul B'di Avad. So it has to be Rabbi Yossi. Ma Shotev Katan Di Avad Namilo. Af Heresh Di Avad Namilo. Says Gemara, who says? The Dilma Hakid Ita Hakid Ita. Maybe they put them all together because they're not Kashil Chatchila. But the Avad, some are good and some are not. Says, no. Me the Katani Sefer, Rabbi Yehuda Machshir B'Katan. Rabbi Yehuda says, you could use a Katan. Michlal, the Reish, Alav Rabbi Yehudahi. The Reish is not Rabbi Yehuda. If Rabbi Yehuda pipes in the Sefer, must be the Reish, it wasn't him. Doesn't make sense to say the Reish is Rabbi Yehuda. And it's saying a Heresh. Could read b'di avad b'na l'chatchila, and then he pipes Rabbi Yehuda Omer, What do you mean? Hare the Reish also. The Reish is mashma that a shote katan is pasul, but the avar Rabbi Yudah says it's kasher. Says Gemara, who says v'dil makula Rabbi Yudah? Maybe I'll say the whole Mishnah is Rabbi Yudah. V'tre gavne katan katanim. And when the Mishnah is saying Rabbi Yudah machshir b'katan, it's not talking about the same katan that we said, but it's a new type of katan. What's that? V'chesura mechzera. There's a line missing in the Mishnah. V'achi katani. Hakol kesherin likrot at the Megillah. Everybody is kasher to read the Megillah. Chutz meheresh shote v'katan. V'amed varim orim that a katan is pasul b'katan shelo yigil lechinuch. That's if you're not of the age of education. Alo b'katan shegil lechinuch. Once he's of the age that you have to educate him and read in the Megillah, so he has a chiyuv to read the Megillah midrabanan. Avo b'katan shegil lechinuch afilu lechatchila. He can read it lechatchila because his chiyuv is the rabanan, is poter. Everybody's chiyuv, which is the rabanan. Rabbi Yehuda machshir bekatan. Rabbi Yehuda allows the katan to read the Megillah. Who's magil lechinuch? Okay. So how are you understanding the Mishnah? B'mayu kimta k'Rabbi Yehuda v'di avad. You're saying the El Mishnah that says that a Hiresh can't read it is Rabbi Yehuda. And why can't he read it? No, he can't read it lechatchila. But v'di avad, it's okay. Ela hadetani Rabbi Yehuda bered Rabbi Shimon ben Pazi. So you're understanding what Rabbi Yehuda said, Hakoret Shema V'lo Yishmel Zon Yatsa is only with the Avad Yotze, but not Lechatchila. He says, I have a problem.
That's how they understand Rabbi Yehuda.
That's why it says, El Mishnah that says, Hakol Chutz Meheresh is not Lechatchila, but with the Avad it's okay. So we have two opinions. Rabbi Yehuda, who says, if you didn't hear yourself, it's okay with the Avad. And Rabbi Yossi says, if you didn't hear yourself, it's pasul, right? Nobody holds l'chatchila you can read without hearing yourself. Ad katani, Rabbi Yehuda bered Rabbi Shimon Pazi cheresh hamedaber ve'eno shomea torem l'chatchila. There a cheresh that speaks and doesn't hear, he could take terumah l'chatchila. What's the problem taking terumah? No, when you take terumah, you have to make a beracha. So if the cheresh, if his beracha doesn't count, so he shouldn't do it because he can't make a beracha. So who says he can be torem lechatchila? Because he'll say the beracha without hearing himself. Who's that? Rabbi Yossi. No good. The avad namilo. Ve'elamai Rabbi Yehuda. Afilu lechatchila. You see Rabbi Yehuda, he holds even lechatchila. So why did he say in the Mishnah, Hakoret Shema V'lo Yishmel Zon Yatsa? Because he was talking on a B.O.C. term. Lo yatsa, he said yatsa. But be'etzim, he could do lechatchila. Ela. Okay. Ve'ela, my, Rabbi Yehuda, v'afilu lechatchila. So now you want to argue with me. You want to tell me that Rabbi Yehuda really holds that if you don't hear yourself, that's fine. It's lechatchila. And a B.O.C. holds it's b'di'avad. So there's no middle position, right? There's either it's 100% good or it's 100% bad. But nobody holds in the middle that lechatchila, no, but b'di'avad, yes. Don't say Birkat HaMazon thinking. And if he did it, Yatsa, Mani. Who's that? Lord Rabbi Yehuda, but Lord Rabbi Yossi. It's not Rabbi Yehuda because he holds Lechatchila, read it. It's not Rabbi Yossi because with the Avad it's no good. Ir Rabbi Yehuda, filo Lechatchila. Ir Rabbi Yossi, filo the Avad, namilo. So we answer, Le'olam, Rabbi Yehuda. Really, I'll tell you it's Rabbi Yehuda. Va'afilu lechatchila, and he holds even lechatchila. Le'olam rivda filu lechatchila, ve'lo kashya. Hadideh hadirabe. Rabbi Yehuda holds two positions. His position is, you could even do it lechatchila, but his Rabbi holds it's only good b'di avad. Detanya Rabbi Yehuda umem mishum Rabbi Elazar ben Azariya kore shema. The person reads shema. Tzarich shiyashmiya le'ozno. He has to make it hurt his ears. Shneemar shema Yisrael Hashem Elokeinu Hashem Echad. Hashma le'oznecha ma she'ata umetze mipicha.
What?
All the same. L'chatchila, you have to hear yourself. He only says tzarich. But he doesn't say b'di'avad, it's no good. Rabbi Meir omer, you only have to think it. Or you don't have to hear yourself. So we want to say that Rabbi Yehuda, in the name of Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah, holds the chatchila, you have to hear yourself. But Rabbi Yehuda himself holds, you don't have to hear yourself. And then the end of the Baraita quotes Rabbi Meir, who also says, Ahar kavanata levin advanim. So Elazar, hashda dati lahachi. Now that he quoted that Mishnah, filu temer Rabbi Yehuda kerebes filu. If you want to say Rabbi Yehuda holds like his Rebbe, and the chatchila, you have to hear yourself, but the avar, it's good. Had a tani Rabbi Yehuda bered Rabbi Shimon ben Pazi that torem lechatchila, even though he doesn't hear himself, Rabbi Meir, he goes like Rabbi Meir, who says even lechatchila you don't have to hear yourself. Comes out according to this.